Welcome back to another episode of Navi News Daily. So this one's on site. We are at The Culture in Rochester, New York. If you don't know who this is standing to my right, you will throughout the rest of this season. If you've been watching the Yorton Cup, you know I'm standing next to the Yorton Cup champ, Liz Gangali. So Liz, this is what, second interview, maybe third video that you've been in. This one's a little different. Coming off a big win, heading into, as of recording, this is Wednesday. I think.
Yes.
I'm getting out of prep brain. She's still in prep brain, right? So Wednesday leading up to the Mr. America, which is obviously your next big showdown. Coming off the win, we talked a little bit, not really digging too much, filling out. So we're going to be kind of fly on the wall, following along. You said a little bit of legs, maybe a little bit of upper body. It's peak week training, so it's going to be intense, but not as much. But yeah, what do you want to say to the viewers? I'm putting you on the spot.
I know you love that. I don't know what to say.
So what are the emotions going in after coming off such a, like, that was, I mean, historic really is the word for it, right? Yorton Cup, big title, especially on the women's side of the sport. That has been huge for years. It was no easy win, right? The returning champ was there. You knock her off. She's going to be at this next show again. So kind of what are the emotions going into the Mr. America, which is, again, arguably another huge title?
For Mr. America, I'm just excited because for this year, I wanted to dabble in women's bodybuilding, which is kind of why I chose to do Mr. America. So I don't really have like any expectations. I'm just excited to be there.
Okay. I have my expectations, but I'm very superstitious, so I'm not going to say anything. So, but yeah, we're going to get into some training. I'll be popping some questions in as we go. And then I think we're going to do a little posing with MC maybe after the fact.
Yep.
So you guys might get to see that, might not. It all depends on what I'm allowed to show. So, all right. Tune in, guys.
She could definitely use more carbs right now. And sometimes, like, obviously through peak week, you should get more carbs in the mix, but you have to be careful because you don't want a spillover effect. Not that I think she's going to spill over per se, but you want to be able to show striation, but show the right type of fullness. So in this situation, this is exactly how Yorin was. I took one look at her and I was like, more carbs.
Yeah.
And I upped her by like 50 that day.
Yep.
And for some people that scares them. I'm like, nope, I know how her body handles it.
Mm-hmm.
So like I'm looking at her right now, I'm like, I can go higher.
Yeah.
And then I would go higher, like if I were to increase by like 30 or 40, we're gonna keep that 30 or 40. I'm not gonna pull back the next day kind of thing too. So Because some people will like play it out and be like, oh, let's just leave it there and then tomorrow do the same thing. Mm-hmm. No, because I know her body can handle more and I know it needs more. And we're almost at the stage where she's been in a deficit or dieting for so long that it's almost like you could feed her with a lot right now.
Yep.
And her body's going to take to it really well. So it'll make her happy to eat more.
Absolutely.
She'll never say no to me.
Yeah. Ivan was like, you're looking a little flyish. And I was like, does that mean more carbs?
Yeah.
One, the thing too is this situation recreates. I mean, she's going to pump up pre-stage. We just had a workout. So you could say, like, oh, she's depleted from the workout.
Yeah.
But you want to see what she's going to look like with a pump anyway, right? Yeah. So if she's flat now, she's certainly going to be flat on stage. Totally. So, yeah.
In full transparency, though, I've only really had breakfast today. Just because I trained earlier, so I didn't fit like 2 minutes. Okay. And then I had some of the bites of that. Yesterday I had 2 meals before. But I woke up at like 9:15, 9:30, so I was like,
tomorrow I would want you to eat more carbs before you train. And I want, because he'll take video too for tomorrow, and he'll send it to me too. So I want to see you take in. Well, I have to look at your meals for tomorrow. What time are you leaving tomorrow? Right afterwards?
Mm-hmm. I mean, yesterday I had like 150 carbs before coming here. And then you saw the video he sent last night.
Yeah. I think we can push more pre and post, which is what I would want to do. Because if we can get in more, you got to think of the fact that like we're thinking there's a 3 p.m., 4 p.m. show time. So I want to just know that we're getting in that same amount leading up to that time frame as when we can replicate it for Saturday the right way. Obviously, the last show you went on earlier in the day, which is also why we started eating at 3 o'clock in the morning or whatever it was. So, yeah. I'm gonna send you some instructions for tonight in order to get in more carbs today. And then where I wanna see added in to what you're already eating, I don't want you to change the sources, I just want more of what you're having. So,
that's typically where rice cakes and potatoes are implemented, obviously.
Look at that smile, that's the best
part. I love carbs.
She's like, I'll eat 400 grams of potatoes, no problem.
Yeah, potatoes are the best.
I know.
Why don't we run through one more time that I want you to eat? Yeah. Your turn.
Yeah. I know, I'm always torn though. Because I think for bodybuilding, you have to keep it here, right? You don't extend?
Correct.
So, last year, thigh and abdominal, they asked for us to extend. Which I was like, sweet.
Definitely more carbs.
Hit that sartorius again. Huh? Hit that sartorius again. Okay. I want to see it. Yeah, what you did the first pose, yeah. Just the separation, yeah. I mean, like.
She had her posing suit on too, just like this upper outer meat. It's just, yeah. It's like that she did not have last prep. These striations she did not have last prep. Yeah. So to see, it's that off season, it's the improvement season that makes such a critical difference. Mm-hmm. And I mean, we pushed hard. I mean, she was eating on a regular basis, like I think the lowest her carbs was were around like 315, right?
I was at like, yeah, I think around, it was a little over 300 or 300 for...
Yeah, fats were way up because, in my opinion, if you are not addressing hormonal health through your improvement season and getting to the best possible health markers in the improvement season, I think that's a problem too. I think a lot of people don't think of that kind of stuff as much because they just hire a coach when they're ready to prep.
Yep.
But that improvement season is so critical. It's the time for your coach to learn about your body so much too. So I just...
She reels me in too.
Yeah, I mean,
I got really stuck on the sugar-free things, so she had to bring
me into the sugar-free things. Yeah. I'm a big, big whole foods kind of person.
Oh, yeah.
Just because it's off season, I don't want to see you sucking back Ghost Energy drinks and Diet Coke. None of that. There's no, people tend to get like those skinny syrups and all that too. Or just,
it was the pudding mix.
The pudding mix. Really
I put pudding
me.
Mix in everything.
Protein concoctions. Stop it with the protein concoctions. Yeah. Just stop it.
Just sludge and cake and
the
yeah.
The day
yeah.
she told me was like, in the morning I went to Walmart and like, there's a Walmart out here that has so many flavors. I picked up 14 boxes, and then I get a message later, and she's like, serving a day.
Slow down. Like, I got a protein creamy and a protein cake and a protein cookie. Stop it with all that.
Yeah.
Put
yeah.
some chicken in your body, please.
Yeah, chicken and rice, beef and rice.
Yeah.
Fish and rice.
Yeah, simple. Rice, I forgot about that.
Everyone goes through that phase, I feel like.
Yeah.
You like
it's Instagram.
Instagram or, you know, all those little ingredients and and it's game over.
All right, so it's our second time on the couch, right? We chatted with Liz a little bit earlier about just how she's feeling, how the show went, like the emotions going in there. Big show again. But what I wanted to chat with you about, and we can talk off air, your nutritional strategies. That's your bread and butter, that's your specialty. It's kind of, from my understanding, you've been a nutrition while I've been in this training.
Yeah.
And it's obviously worked very, very well. I was commenting that the photos that we saw come out of your striations are just absolutely nuts. So, talk me through kind of what we were chatting about. You know, are we fat loading? Are we carb loading? Are we depleting? What's the magic behind it, if you don't mind sharing?
Yeah, so I think first and foremost, you have to look at how long you've been in a relationship with your athlete, right? She came to us saying like, hey, I'm interested in bodybuilding. I have a gymnastics background, and I'll never forget it. The first time she worked out with Ivan and I looked straight at Ivan, and I was like, holy cow, like, she's going to be something. And even then, not having a proper nutrition protocol in place, and honestly looking like really good for somebody who doesn't work out and doesn't work on things like protein, carbs, and fats. So it was just using that time frame to learn about how her body was running and what made it tick, per se. Because then, going into her first ever show that we did, it was kind of like a learning process through the whole thing that we started to see like, okay, she favors carbs very heavily. And she does really well when we light up with certain types of carbs. So I remember specifically during her very first show prep that we did, telling her like, we're gonna switch off from, you know, using certain carb sources to instead going to potatoes. All of a sudden potatoes was like her thing, right? So I kept her like, air fry those potatoes, get them dry as can be, like add those to your, you know, your regimen and certain times of day and how much we were loading in the pre and the post workout. And then it was learning what times of day does her body look its very best and how do I replicate that when it comes to her schedule overall. So through her, you know, first peak week, we kind of learned a lot of that kind of stuff together last year. And then in the improvement season, it was just, let's load up. Let's do the best we can to get this nutrition sky high, because then it gives me room to play when it does come time to diet her down. And I know you and I talked about it, that pre-prep diet to really get back into the habits that are so important to us during a prep that we take for granted. Your sodium intake, your what you're taking, bites, licks, and tastes of that you don't even realize you're doing, or not measuring certain things. in particular with her, sodium is such a big part of the game. Everybody jokes with me that like salt is my favorite topic, and truthfully speaking, it is. I talk to all of my athletes about it, but her in particular, keeping the salt at a really substantial amount through the prep itself so that she did continue to feel good on a daily basis. But then, so I had room to play with it through peak weeks. So then come time for the Yorin, you know, I said to her, we're gonna do a very minor depletion for a couple days. And by depletion, I was joking with you, at, you know, 200 carbs isn't exactly a depletion to me as a bikini competitor and pro, but for her, you know, bringing her down and bringing the fats down enough so that the body truly wasn't a depleted state, so that I could build her back up. So for her in particular, we don't just do a 7 day out peak. We're pretty much, I mean, we're the final 4 weeks, I'm really like studying photos every day. I'm studying body weight and what are we noticing in how the body looks post workout, 2 days later from leg day, things of that nature, to really learn how does her body handle these circumstances, because then I don't want any stones to need to be turned when it comes to peak week. I want to practice everything ahead of time and just implement. So when it came time to implement for peak week for Yorin, it was, we're going to deplete down to your carbs, and then I want to slowly add, and I want to see you posing, and I want to see how you look a few hours later, so on and so forth. I want to climb that sodium. I want to get you to a place where the fats are making sense. We're climbing those as well. A lot of people you'll find will just put a ton of carbs in and pray that works. I was like, no. I saw the way giving her some steak a few weeks prior had helped her body stick those carbs and made her look fuller. And I was like, all right, like we practiced it. Let's put it to work. And so it was about building the fats the right way along with the carbs that made sense. The sodium, and really not playing too high with the water. Another thing that I feel a lot of people go crazy, 1.5 gallons, 2 gallons of water. If you're not conditioned enough, the water manipulation is not going to really help. All the sodium and carbs in the world, you're going to be throwing a Hail Mary. I want to know specifics, and I want to be as scientifically based as I can with it, so that when we hit the stage, I knew at that time of day what she was going to look like and how it was going to play out on stage. And I tell her all the time, her body is so unique and different as it is. So we want to just take it to the next level with having the right nutrition in place. And, you know, post Yorin and then coming into Mr. A now, it was about, let's get back like to where your pre-peak week macros were. And then we're going to do probably a smaller depletion again and then build you back up similar ways. But we didn't need to go as crazy with it just because we did that upfront depletion. And then her body just, I knew it was going to take off with it like it has in the past. So it's really just about playing to what's worked in the past that you've learned about your athlete. But more importantly, how do you build on these foundations to create better peaks as we move forward to it?
Well, practice makes perfect, right?
Yes,
and so that's something that I am personally a coach trying to do. And it bothers me so much when you see these plans from other coaches where it's, they haven't had more than 200 grams of carbs in 3 months, and all of a sudden, here's 700 grams of carbs and zero fats. And it's like, it's a guess. Like, where are we getting these numbers from?
Yeah.
But with you guys, everything's very calculated. I think I just watched you measure a lot, right? So in everything to the T, you know exactly what's going in, so you know what the outcome is going to be. That's huge when you're as lean as you are, right? Because it's very easy to go a little too flat, a little too full. When you're not lean enough, it doesn't matter if you can't see those differences, but when you're playing with that top 1%, it all comes out. So I'm excited to see what it looks like round two, which we've got, 2 days, 3 days? Where are we at?
Yeah, so
three days.
Yeah.
Three days out.
Yeah.
So we're kind of in the middle of that phase then, right? You did your depletion already.
Yeah.
Are we kind of loading at this point now?
Yes. Okay. So carbs are coming up and they go up by bigger amounts, obviously. Knowing really, once again, seeing how her body peaked last time and knowing, okay, like we're going to pull through the majority of those protocols, but we have more game to be able to play now that I saw how that worked out. knows, like, grade A psycho. Your water, your sodium, I want everything on a scale. Because like you said, when you get to this level, when you are this type of unique body, you should be treated that way also. And I think your coach should be just as much in it with you and, you know, getting to the nitty gritty. I mean, there's times she's texting me at 3:30 in the morning with photos and I'm answering right back at 3:30. And, you know, some coaches might wait till it's more convenient for their schedule, but I feel like you owe your athlete that. They're going to give you everything. I want to give everything back. So my crazy tendencies may have rubbed off a little bit on Liz, but maybe that's not such a bad thing.
I love it.
Well, that's, I mean, it gets brought up a lot. I mean, the coaching industry right now is flooded with people that probably shouldn't be coaching. But if the athlete is paying a premium, you should provide a premium, right?
Totally.
So I totally get the work-life balance. I've gone too far in one way where I have to pull myself back and set some boundaries. But when you've got a high-level prep athlete that's weeks out, there is no balance, right? You're as extreme as they are.
Yeah, and that moment when she won and just like screaming into the video of like watching it, because I wasn't there in the actual show, I was like, I kept saying like I'm sweating and now I'm like freezing and I don't know what's going on. And it was like one of those moments where it's like an out of body experience to watch what you worked on as a team so closely, to watch it come to life and to see it under those lights. And just like I was saying to you before, when you put her against everybody else, I said there was just, she looked like unbelievable on that stage. And I was super proud for not only for Liz, but for her village of people that were there to support her. And, you know, because as we talk about bodybuilding, yes, it's a very solo sport, but it's not. Your village and the people who love you and care about you, they're as much in it as you are. So
yeah. All right, so I think we're gonna do a little posing.
Yeah.
Right. And we had talked earlier about maybe you making some on the fly changes to the macros based on what you see with the posing. So I kinda wanna see that thought process where it might be up while she's posing, and whatever you want to share, we'll share. Whatever is secret, we'll cut out.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Let's get to it so Liz can eat and then relax a little.
All right guys, so we are back in the office after our session with Liz and MC and the crew at Ivan's Fitness, Ivan himself. So always appreciative to those guys that let me kind of come into the gym and chat it up with their athletes. We've done two interviews there now, one following the OCB show, and then now just kind of with Liz specifically and MC to kind of pick their brains on the nutrition, because seeing Liz's conditioning at the Yorton Cup, I mean, that was something special. Right, so those are the kind of things we want to highlight and pick the brains of, right? Because this podcast, as much as it is for entertainment, it's for education as well, or at least we hope that it is. Not that any one team, athlete, or coach has the exact recipe for every person, but if you start to see a consensus forming of the way that these high-level athletes perform and act, you might pick up on a few things yourself. So if you like this episode, please give us a like, subscribe, share, follow, all the good stuff so that we can continue to grow the sport and continue to grow this platform. And we'll see you guys in the next one.